And coming up, how is the Bahamas telecommunications company preparing for competition?
Officials at the Lyndon Pinling International Airport are looking to spread some love this Valentine's. With whom, you may ask? The answer coming up in the Bahamas Tonight.
Now in HD. Network presents The Bahamas Tonight. This portion of the news brought to you by BTC Every Day.
Good evening, everyone. I'm LaDawn Davis, and welcome to The Bahamas Tonight, the weekend edition. Thanks for tuning in. Topping the news tonight, in just a few months, the cellular landscape will change in the Bahamas, creating competition and options to Bahamian consumers. Now that the government has made public the three companies vying for the second cellular license, what impact will this have on the Bahamas telecommunications company, who currently has the monopoly on cellular services? Well, the company's top executive says whenever the time comes for that license to be granted, They will be ready. That story tonight from C.S. Gradley.
CEO of the Bahamas Telecommunications Company, Leon Williams, says BTC will do its best to stay ahead of the curve on technology. Just this week, the government announced that three companies submitted requests for proposals for the second cellular license. But Williams says the company is not overly concerned with competition.
BTC has been competing in the internet space since 1996. We were not the first to launch internet. We were not the first to launch high speed. We did not launch our high speed internet until 2002. We started competing in the long distance space and in the fixed line space in 2004. So the only space we have not competed in is the mobile space. So competition is not something that is strange to BTC. It's not foreign to BTC. My thing is that we'll gear up the 700 plus staff at BTC because we don't want anybody coming in our backyard to eat our lunch, our dinner, and our supper.
While understanding that the government must do what it has to do, Williams maintains that it will be up to BTC employees to do what they must to save their jobs.
Competition gives us the best products, but it changes people as well. The pie is just so big. There are 350,000 people in the Bahamas. All you're doing is just slicing and dicing the pie. So we at BTC would have had 100% of the pie. Now the pie gets divided in two. Delay it until 2 years down, the pie gets divided in three. So it's a matter of how you fight for a bigger slice of the pie. So the division of the pie just simply means that you have to change how you do business I suppose determine how you're going to secure your market share.
Once the successful bidder has been chosen, the BTC CEO says the Bahamas telecommunications company will move ahead with strategies to maintain its edge in the market while keeping a strong customer base.
If it is Cable Bahamas, then there's one strategy. If it's a Digicel, there's another strategy. If it is Virgin Mobile, it's a different strategy. You know, so there's no single strategy to do it. What is common, however, is that we've got to build a resilient network, a network that is prepared for the future, with competition or without competition. We've got to have a resilient network.
Virgin Mobile Bahamas, Digicel Bahamas, and Cable Bahamas Limited are all vying for the second cellular license, and that decision is expected to be made by May. C.S. Gatterley, ZNS Network News.
Meanwhile, BTC continues to increase its presence in the market, opening its 20th retail store today. This time, the telecoms giant has partnered with the College of the Bahamas to open its newest location in the Chapter 1 bookstore. Company CEO Leon Williams says the store will serve as a much-needed amenity for the student population.
We've partnered with the College of the Bahamas through a franchise holder, Mr. Green, to open up a store here. In the bookstore, so that the students at the College of the Bahamas, to be the University of the Bahamas, would have access to modern telecommunications, rather than having to track all the way to the mall or to Southwest Plaza. But right on campus, they would have all their telecommunications needs met.
While the country's main revenue collection agency is making good strides, the Customs Department has already collected close to $10 million in revenue for the year. Based on its success so far, Assistant Customs Controller Tony Scriven says the department was ready for the rollout of value-added tax on January 1st after making the necessary adjustments, including the installation of a new IT system. Now they are working to ensure the conduct of both officers and consumers are above board, because he says corruption will not be tolerated, and those who attempt to defraud the system will be forced to face the consequences and stiff penalties, which range from fines to imprisonment. He believes VAT's implementation has also helped to safeguard against it.
When you look at the VAT laws, there are some serious penalties for individuals who are responsible for collecting value-added tax, and by extension, a customs officer is a VAT officer. And so if you're found to be corrupt, the penalty could be very severe. And the Customs Department, as every other department, we try to keep corruption out. And we now have what we call a post-clearance audit system, whereby we can go back and check the importers' goods and the level of importation, and if we found it to be unsavory.
In crime news this weekend, police are reporting more success under their anti-crime operation. They arrested a 45-year-old man in the Kemp Road area last night after discovering a handgun along with 16 rounds of ammunition in his possession. 13 other suspects were arrested for a number of criminal offenses, including possession of dangerous drugs with the intent to supply and outstanding court warrants. Southwestern Division officers also conducted an operation in the division on Friday targeting persons wanted for various criminal offenses. During the operation, two vehicles suspected of being stolen were recovered, and two persons were arrested and taken into custody. 12 persons were also arrested for various offenses, including housebreaking, stealing, and breach of the Immigration Act. The Constitutional Commission expanding its campaign across the Bahamas. The group took its educational forum on the gender equality bills to Ragged Island on Friday. Cleopatra Murphy was there.
A strong showing for Ragged Islanders at the Constitutional Commission's Public Education Forum on proposed changes to the Constitution on that island Friday morning. The numbers were bolstered by students from Ragged Island All-Age School after Principal Robert Boudram decided to incorporate it into the lesson plan.
I decided to bring the students here because part of our social study curriculums deals with the Constitution, and they need to know more about that aspect. But all in all, I'm very appreciative of whatever we have learned, and the children were able to have some knowledge so that they can be able to go on.
Boudram, who's taught in the Bahamas for 12 years and had two children born here, also used the time to get his questions in regarding citizenship. The commission actively engaged the students, and one of them, Julia Smith, says she supports what the four constitutional amendment bills represent and sees how she will benefit from their passage in the future.
The biggest thing I took away from this meeting was the learning about the equalities of men and women that they should have. And I feel I agree with the Constitution and what they're about to do, and I hope that the government do pass these laws.
Also attending the forum was resident Juliet Kirthaya Ochoa, whose eight-year marriage to a Cuban national brought the issues of citizenship addressed by the commission close to home. For her, the gender equality bills are important.
I was very concerned about the amendment to the bills that they were proposing pertaining to children born to foreign spouses, and also pertaining to the sexual discrimination. I solely agree with everything, that men and women should have the same rights.
The commission travels next week to South Andras and Mangrove Key. Cleopatra Murphy, ZNS Network News.
And still to come, it's Valentine's Day, a look at the specials and much sought-after gifts around town.